This is an
old city.
This is a
beautiful city.
This is an
artistic city.
This is the
sweetest city.
This is the
city of devotees.
This is
Bhaktapur.
And today I'm going to tell you four reasons to never ever visit Bhaktapur. When I came to Nepal for the first time 14 and a half years ago, the first place my husband took me to was Nagarkot. And on the way, we stopped over at Bhaktapur. And when I came here for the first time, I fell in love. Real love. True love. Deep love. You see, Bhaktapur is one of the most glorious places in Nepal. It is a small town around 13 kilometers from the center of Kathmandu within the Kathmandu Valley. And today I'm going to tell you all about it. It was the largest of the three Neva kingdoms of the valley and also the capital of Nepal until the mid-15th century. It has the best preserved courtyard and the Bhaktapur Darbar Square is famous all over the world for its rich stoneworks, artworks and metal sculptures. It is also listed as a World Heritage Site by the UNESCO. But today, I'm going to tell you some of the reasons you should never ever visit this place. The city itself was built in the 12th century and the Bhaktapur Darbar Square has many statues, palaces and monoliths all starting from the 15th century onwards. The square itself is a charming compound consisting the 55-window palace with its golden gate, the Vatsala Temple, statue of Bhupatindra Malla, Nyatapola Temple, Bhairavnath Temple among many others. Being here is like being in a painting or being in a movie set. Every corner, every street, every pillar is so beautiful and so full of life and energy, although it was built so long ago. But this is the exact reason why you should never ever visit Bhaktapur. You see, it's just too beautiful. You want to take it all in. You want to soak it all in. Your eyes are bedazzled by the beauty. Your neck is going to hurt because you'll want to look at everything all around. And your feet, well, even if you're tired, your feet will not want to stop because you'll want to discover every nook and cranny and corner of this beautiful, completely out of the world place. So, if you have a free day and if you don't want to get tired walking around, seeing things and taking all the beauty in, never ever visit Bhaktapur. The town of Bhaktapur was made centuries ago. So many of the old streets still have that old world charm. They are preserved in the way they were made many, many, many years ago. When you're walking through these cities, you'll be very, very pleased to find akhijal or beautifully carved ornate windows. You'll see old ladies sitting and basking in the sun. Walking through these cobbled, meandering streets is almost like walking into a time machine. It's all so well preserved. It really gives you a good glimpse of how life was lived many, many years ago. Pure, simple, and easy. But you? Don't you like your big modern skyscrapers? Don't you like all the beauties that the modern world brings? Well, if you like everything that's modern, if you like everything that's glitzy and glamorous, never ever visit Bhaktapur. Because visiting Bhaktapur is like going back into a time machine, going back into simpler and more beautiful days that our ancestors had the privilege of living in. So, if you want the modern world, never ever visit Bhaktapur. Each corner of this city feels like an art museum. Its artisans are masters at metalwork, stonework, woodwork, pottery, and even painting. I have personally got a chance to visit the Lama Thanka Painting School at Bhaktapur. When I visited here, I realized that all of these people create these works of magic. Somehow, it seems like they've been specially blessed by their ancestors. When I came here, I too was tempted to try and paint some. And that's exactly what I did. However, once I started painting, I realized that my artistic abilities in no way can match up to the wonderful works that these people create. So if you too, just like me, don't want to feel terrible about your own artistic abilities, please, please never visit Bhaktapur because the people here are master artisans and they will make you, if you're anything like me, feel really embarrassed about your own skills. Number 4, Juju Dhau. My videos are never complete without food, are they? Well, not just mine. No video on Bhaktapur can ever be complete without the mention of Juju Dhau. Juju Dhau is the perfect yogurt. It's translated as the king's curd. Juju Dhau is served in earthen pots. It's not too sweet, it's not too savory. It's just right. Juju Dhau is beautiful, and especially on a hot summer day, if you have a spoonful of Juju Dhau, it can completely change your mood. But here's the fun fact. The real original Juju Dhau is only available in Bhaktapur. So, once you come here, that taste may linger in your mouth for many, many, many days. So if you don't want to miss that taste of Juju Dhau after you've gone away from Bhaktapur, never ever visit Bhaktapur. So, if you don't want to get tired seeing all this beauty, if you don't want to miss your modern skyscrapers, if you don't want to feel like you have zero artistic ability, and if you don't want to miss the taste of the most beautiful yogurt ever,
never ever visit Bhaktapur.